Klaša.
Hello fanatics, Crazy Russian Dad here with you, and today I want to do something special. I want to tell you a Russian joke. Actually, it's a Soviet joke. And I know that jokes and humor in general, they do not translate well, but I will try. By the way, did you know that Russians call jokes anecdotes? Anecdote. There are two separate words. There is a word for joke, and then there is the word anecdote. Hold on. Bad intersection. This anecdote goes way back into the hallowed antiquity of the Soviet Union. This joke is about Leonid Brezhnev. He was a president, you could say, prime minister, leader of the Soviet Union for a long time. He came right after like Stalin and Khrushchev, and he presided over a period of relative calmness, you know, for the citizens of the Soviet Union. By the way, you need to know that the leader of the Soviet Union was not prime minister or president. The leader of the Soviet Union was known as comrade, general, secretary of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union. I will repeat, comrade, general, secretary of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union. Why? Because the party and the country were seen as one and the same. It's pretty scary. By the way, this is not yet the joke. I am just like setting it up. And by the way, I'm not yet even done with the setup. So Leonid Brezhnev, when he took over, he was, you know, full of energy and charismatic, you know, and popular, just like any politician needs to be, right? But in his later years, became not as sharp. He became old and sort of a bit senile. We could just see it in his television appearances. His speech became slower, and it was clear that sort of he was not as mentally alert than he once was.
Чтобы годы детства были здоровыми и счастливыми.
Of course, in those days in the Soviet Union, the great leader did not retire. There was only two ways to stop being a great leader. You could die, it happens to the best of us. The other way to stop being a great leader is to be removed from power and usually promptly executed for being an enemy of the state. And Soviet citizens, sort of in a whisper in their own kitchen, would poke gentle fun at Leonid Brezhnev in his sort of a loss of mental capacities. The year was 1980. This is when Russia was hosting the Olympics. Finally, you're ready for the joke. So Leonid Brezhnev gets on the podium, and then he gets the sheet of paper out. Why? Because he had to read off the sheet of paper, right? Because he couldn't probably remember what to say. And this is before teleprompters. I hear that American presidents look at the teleprompter, maybe not always, and maybe not all of them, I don't know, but there was certainly no teleprompter for Leonid Brezhnev. Okay, finally, the joke. Brezhnev is on the podium speaking, you know, to a huge audience of people. He takes the sheet of paper out and he says, "Oh!" And everybody, you know, everybody clapping vigorously, right? By the way, O is a Russian letter, you know, like your American O. And again, Brezhnev looks at his sheet of paper and says, "Oh!" And everybody's clapping like big time. You have to, because if you don't clap, you know, during the speech of the great leader, you know, somebody will tell on you and you won't be clapping ever again. And yet again Brezhnev says, "Oh!" And at this time it's like бурные продолжительные аплодисменты, which means like vigorous and long standing ovation and everything. So finally Handler runs in, you know, stops by, and whispers into his ear, "Comrade General Secretary, these are the Olympic rings." You get it? Yes, he was reading the Olympic rings. Is it funny? It's probably a bad joke if you have to explain it afterwards, but I had to explain it before, during, and after. I probably failed miserably, but if you found it funny, you're welcome. And if you didn't find it funny, I told you up front that humor just does not translate well. So, like, give me a break. Like, it was really funny 38 years ago in 1980. Thank you so much for watching Crazy Russian Dad. Please subscribe, like, support, follow all of those things, buy my merchandise, I don't know, whatever else you're supposed to do when following awesome celebrities that give you wonderful educational content, you know, like Crazy Russian Dad. I'm just joking. Thank you and good night.